Education, bro, is that's a standard. That's a baseline. Whereas learning, oh, that's unscripted. That's uncharted waters. And today, more so than ever, bro, that's a lifeline. Learning how to learn is a game changer, a total game changer. In government, in universities, in K-12, and all of us are right now, we're learning how to learn. I can't think of a time such as the days that we're in right now that we're all on an even playing field. We are. The days where you said, damn, dude, I wish I had an advantage over the next man. Well, bro, you just got it. It's as if the universe said, okay, I'll grant you your wish. Someday has arrived. And I've said for years, man, I said, stop living in the eighth day of the week someday, because it ain't never happening. Well, never say never, because someday is here. You know those days where you said, someday I'll get around to learning these different skills. Someday I'll get around to starting my business. Someday I'll get around to learning more. Someday I'll learn how to use social media. Someday, 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 someday. And you're always waiting on someday. Well, someday is here. I mean, businesses, the education system, government, individuals, all of us, man, we're having to learn how to learn instead of learn how to educate. See, education is teaching you to a standard. So for instance, if you're in 10th grade, I can teach you to get through 10th grade. I'm going to teach you to a standard of 10th grade. I'll get you familiar with 11th, but I'm going to educate you just with those skills of 10th. And then once you get to 11th, then 11th handles itself. See, there's a wall, there's a barrier there of that education. So I'll get you to a point and then we stop there. You pass, and then you go on to one step above. That's what education is. See, when I hired you in sales, I can educate you with the skills to be able to hold your own at least. Average, 10 to 12, maybe 15 cars. But learning, that's a whole different level. See, as the, if you're the mayor, man, if you're a government official, see, you've got the qualifications, enough qualifications in order to get elected into the office. Or what about the shed that you bought at Lowe's, man? The shed that you bought at Lowe's, well, in order to put it all together, man, you're going to need an instruction manual. And see, that instruction manual will educate you on how all the pieces come together. Education, bro, is that's a standard. That's a baseline. Whereas learning, oh, that's unscripted. That's uncharted waters. And today, more so than ever, bro, that's a lifeline. Learning how to learn is a game changer, a total game changer. In government, in universities, in K-12, and all of us are right now, we're learning how to learn. Businesses are closed down, man. Dining rooms are shut down. And all of those owners, what they're having to do is they're having to scramble how to reinvent their business, how to not only survive this market shift, but also how to thrive. How where some business owners just shut the doors and say, I can't do anything at all. I'm locked until the government says, okay, I can do something. And there are other owners that are sitting there saying, yes, I was educated enough to be an owner, but right now I got the license that says I'm an owner, but right now I'm going to learn how to learn. I'm going to learn how to get my product, continue to get my product out there. Yes, the traditional way, the education, the traditional way that I've been doing it all of these kind of different years. That worked for me. But now the entire world has just shifted and I have a choice to make. Do I stay with the education, the broken model right now? Or do I learn how to learn? That's what they're doing. See, education is, it's more of a fixed. It's more of a standard. But learning, man, learning is totally different. It's an exposure. Not only is it exposing you to your weaknesses, but it's also exposing you to new areas that you didn't even think about it, man. It immerses you in different areas that I didn't know. I have this over here. I have this over here. And how do those things work together? Can I go into some sort of affiliation, some sort of joint partnership with a business I never even thought of? And the next thing you know, those things are now, it's a joint collaboration. See, it's an acquisition of all totally different new skills. It's an exposure of not only of your weaknesses too, man, where it exposes your vulnerabilities and you say, I could do this, and I could do this, and I could shift this, and I can open this, and this is what they're saying, but I can shift this over here, and all of a sudden I can still get my message out there. See, this is all new skills, all new techniques, developing new habits. See, no one educated you on the times that we're in right now. No, none of this was on the test. Because that model's broken. Now you gotta learn how to learn. And I'm telling you, bro, I'm telling you, now is your moment. Now is your moment. The entire world has shifted. But don't worry. Don't worry that you're scared. Don't worry that you don't really know. Don't worry that you feel like that you're gonna look stupid. All of us are. All of us are, because this is different for everybody, but not for long. See, teachers are now having to learn creative ways to connect to their students. So instead of all of the rote lesson plans that they've been teaching for all these kind of different years, lulling themselves to sleep, man, just teaching to get through the retirement system or to the retirement system, now all of a sudden teachers say, oh my God, all of my plans, man, I can throw those things out the window. How can I connect to my students? And now they're learning different platforms to be able to connect. They're teaching it in a different way, because their students aren't neatly lined up in these little rows. There's not a, I was gonna say chalkboard. What's the Promethean board? There's not a Promethean board sitting behind me. It's totally different, man. The students are coming in a different way. And now as those teachers, they're alive all of a sudden. Now they're learning creative ways, and now they're awake. They're alive, and they're not just following the outline system, the education model that we've been following for so long. Government, same way, man. Government is the same way. They're learning how to mitigate some of the exposures that they've had. See, government's not running on all four legs. Right now, they're running on one leg. But let me tell you something that's going to be interesting on this. Some of this, because they're running on one leg, they're going to realize, you know what? There's a lot of departments that we got through this for however long. We got through this and we didn't even have a need for that department. As a matter of fact, we're going to eliminate it. See, most people are sitting, you could be, and I'm going to warn you of this, you could be sitting in an educated office right now, meaning that you know there's not a need for you. And I'm telling you, they're going to find out. You're going to get exposed. They're going to realize that I didn't need you this whole time. I don't need that department like I used to, the old education model. I needed that at one time. I don't need that anymore. We're going to eliminate the position. And all of a sudden, man, you're shocked. You're like, oh my God, man, I've given you 23 years of my life, and all of a sudden you guys are going to let me go. That is total BS. No, bro, it was coming the whole time. It's just, you thought you were going to get to the gold watch stage. You thought you were going to put in your 25 and get up out of here and draw a retirement check. And all of a sudden, that official comes in, that business owner comes in and says, oh, game changer, new game. Why are you waiting on them? See, they're going to learn how to learn. So I suggest that you learn how to learn. And you need to strengthen your skills, your techniques, your habits, all kind of different things. And good news is, again, I can't breathe this enough. We're all looking foolish right now. We're all trying to figure this thing out. The education that I got you to 10 to 12 cars, right? But if you want to learn how to sell 20, 30, 40, 50 cars, that's not through an education. See, education is a standard, right? It's a minimum requirement. It's a certification. If you want to get to that whole nother level, man, you're going to get that by education. You're going to get that by learning, where it's 5-6-7-1 ratio. It's where it's the late nights. It's the early mornings. It's learning things that nobody told you. You have to learn this. No. I got this on my own. See, this is on the unscripted part that I'm talking about, where you take it upon yourself and you say, I'm going to figure this thing out. I'm going to mess it up to figure it out, so that I can move not only forward, but up and ahead also. Personal trainers, same thing, man. Personal trainers have made their livelihood on going to a bricks and mortar gym in teaching students. And all of a sudden, what's the first thing, man? When uncertainty comes on, people start pulling their gym memberships, they start pulling their personal trainers out, and personal trainers are now learning how to learn. They're saying, look, I can't connect with you. With the social distancing, and we can't congregate, I can't get a big class, but I don't have the time to go one-on-one, and some people don't want to meet one-on-one. So what is it that I can do? They're learning how to learn how to establish a private platform, so that way at 5:30 every morning, or anytime during the day, you can replay the live training. We don't need weights anymore. We can actually use things in our house, and I'll keep you healthy. And at the same time, they're keeping that income flowing. They're doing a service. They're providing a service for those who want to stay active, man, who are just going bonkers, staring at the four walls, and see, that's the learning how to learn. Not only for the recipient, the one who is on the other side, who is learning the different moves and the techniques, but it's also a win-win situation for all of us, man. You see how that is? It's the same thing, man. This is not business as usual, man. So learning how to learn, man, it's being able to, well, let's take it like this. The education on how to put that shed together, right? So you were educated in how to put that shed together. But along the way, man, you learn different ways that you could actually make that shed maybe a little bit better. Or you learn that I could put barn doors on this thing. And that old engraver that you've had in your garage for all these years that your grandpa left to you and you just kind of threw it aside and you got some old wood in the backyard, now you're learning how to engrave, and now you're engraving barn doors with these cool shapes and all these designs, and all of a sudden, oh my God, I learned how to learn, and now you got a business model. Education waits for you, but learning is rapidly moving ahead. Bro, let me tell you something. The playing field is even, but it's not going to be even very long. Every profession is shaken. And now is not your moment, actually. Now it's your obligation to learn how to learn. Never settle. Keep selling. Keep learning. Stay in the sales line.